Hi everyone, this is your collective tarot reading. In today's video, it is being sponsored by Rose Forever. Rose Forever is a New York-based company that offers a selection of beautiful roses and handcrafted bouquets to choose from. And because Thanksgiving is almost here, I know we don't celebrate it in Australia, but there are a lot of you from the States that watch the channel. Rose Forever would like to make your Thanksgiving even more special this year by offering incredible discounts of up to 70% off site-wide, just in time for Black Friday. But that's not all. Be ready for mind-blowing site-wide discounts that will leave you in awe. Embrace the spirit of Thanksgiving with beautiful roses from Rose Forever, New York. Don't miss out on these amazing discounts and add a touch of elegance to your holiday celebrations. I will include the link to the shop Rose Forever in the description box below. And I will also include a $30 discount code, which is BLACK30. That discount code can be used and applied on any purchase site-wide. So once again, the link to the shop, Rose Forever, is going to be included in the description box below, as well as a $30 discount code, BLACK30. Happy shopping, everyone. With all of that being said, let's go ahead and begin with the reading. So we want to take a look and see what messages are coming up for you. The Six of Wands indicates that you're riding high right now. If you're in a relationship, you and the person that you're connected to, it feels like you're in a really good place. If you are currently single, I feel like there is someone here who is about to enter your life. It feels like a dream partner, okay? Someone who has all the traits and all the characteristics that you want from a partner. I also feel like this is your energy though, very confident, very self-assured here, and you're feeling very good with yourself, okay? I feel like there's some, you're about to reach some success. After all, you're destined for success. So, and I see you sharing your success as well. If there's a goal that you've been working on, if there's a project or a goal or something that you've been working towards, it's very likely that you're going to successfully achieve this goal and you're going to successfully complete this goal. And I also see you sharing the good news with people around you. So it's the Six of Wands indicates success. It is a positive omen. Okay, so if you recently met someone, or if you're putting yourself out there, you know, if you're in a relationship, if you're starting out a new job, a new career, if you're just starting out on a new path, okay, if you feel like you've gotten lost somewhere along the way, and maybe you feel like, you know, you've messed some things up, the Six of Wands indicates that you're going to get back on track. And it tells, especially for those of you that resonate with the message where you feel a little bit lost and off track and a little bit, you know, like you're not on the right track, you're actually exactly where you need to be to get to where it is that you're destined to go. Okay, so, you know, an energy of riding high. If you don't feel like this right now, if this feels very unfamiliar and foreign, this energy to you, then I feel like you're going to be stepping into this energy very soon. I'm not sure exactly what's going to shift in your energy, you know, how you're going to step into this energy, but I feel like there's something here, that's going to, yeah, push you into this energy. Now, with the Five of Swords energy, there is some sort of conflict that is present in the energies, okay? But to me, it feels like some sort of tension is being, or conflict is being relieved here. So you could find yourself walking away from a drama-filled situation. You could find yourself walking away from people that are just nothing but drama. You could find yourself overcoming some sort of obstacle, or overcoming a tension or a conflict of some sort. Okay, so even though the conflict seems to be present in the energies, I feel like you're working through it. So you're either going to be smoothing something over, okay, so smoothing things over with someone whom you've had It feels like this tension with this particular individual has been bubbling. It's just been there for so long and sort of been bubbling up to the surface. And I feel like you will have an opportunity to smooth things over with someone. Or if you just feel like, because remember that people only really understand from their level of perception, right? So if you feel like this person is just committed to misunderstanding you, your best bet might just be to walk away from whatever this is, okay? Walk away from this tension or walk away from this conflict. It doesn't mean you're giving up on this person. It doesn't mean you're turning your back on this person. It just means that, you're accepting that you're never really gonna see eye to eye with this individual, okay? You're accepting that they're constantly just committed to misunderstanding you. And in doing so, I feel like, yeah, you're that tension is being relieved. The Ace of Cups is a reminder, especially, given the season, given that it is Thanksgiving. I feel like the Ace of Cups is a reminder that you're a vessel for deep love. Okay? And there is a lot of love that is flowing, sorry, through you, okay, and into the world. I feel like you're receiving, I'm seeing that you're receiving a lot of love. So this could be an indicator of a new love coming into your life. Okay? You could be attracting someone new, a dream partner, a soulmate. It could also be that you're giving love, okay? But there is this energy of love. It is flowing through you. It's in fact working through you, and I feel like it's overflowing, okay? I feel like there are a lot of people around you who are showing you a lot of love, who are showing you a lot of support. So now could be a really good time to open up your heart and to also open yourself up to experiences as well, because you do not want to close yourself off, okay? Especially for those of you that are single, there is someone new indicated in the cards here for you, and you don't want to close yourself off from this beautiful, loving experience, okay? So there's a rich of emotions available to you right now. Love, there's happiness, there's joy. It's an overflow of emotions. There's also a lot of creative juices flowing here. So if you're someone, if you're a creative, artistic individual, if you are a creator of some sort, I feel like there's a lot of inspiration coming to you. You might have been sitting around and waiting for inspiration to strike, but I feel like it's finally coming to you. It's flowing to you. So you might find that all of a sudden you're getting ideas from, those ideas are just flowing to you. And they're also flowing through you. So there's a lot of inspiration in the energies here. A lot of creativity. I feel like you are love. Right now, I feel like you're very receptive, okay? More so than usual. Your heart chakra may be opening. You're very receptive to love. You're very receptive to new experiences. And you're also receptive to like deep connections. There's also some sort of offer that is being made here. Now, this is an offer of love, okay? This is an offer that I feel like is destined for you. It's divine love. It's divine emotions. This offer, much like the chalice of the like the Ace of Cups, this offers emotional fulfillment. There is something here that is being made available to you. Or there is something here that is, it's directed right at you. It's like this is made for you. It's got your name all over it. But you can only, whatever this is, you can really only embrace this with an open heart. Okay, you cannot embrace this with a closed heart. You cannot embrace this offer, whether it's an offer of love or whether it's an offer of friendship or, whether it's an offer or like a career or a work opportunity, you cannot accept this offer in a blocked energy, in a blocked state. It will not work. It will not work for you. It will not work through you. Okay? And of course, you've got the tower. I don't. Honestly, I feel like there's something here that. Okay, the tower is always about, a collapse of a structure. So yes, there may be some things that are falling apart, but honestly, the way that it feels, it's like something comes apart here only to come back together again. So I see a lot of restructuring happening right now. So for example, you might be, and it's like in different ways. It's, for instance, you could be, working on a creative project, and you might be like picking your project apart, dissecting it, and just restructuring it, moving things around, removing characters, adding new ones, removing scenes, adding different ones. Like, it's just, there's a lot of restructuring, there's a lot of moving blocks and pieces around to make sure they fit. It could also be restructuring, as in you're moving things, okay? You're moving things around the house. So you might be renovating, you might be adding a new story to your home. You might be getting like new furniture. I feel like you're moving things around. You could also be restructuring your daily routine, right? You could be paying closer attention to your habits, your daily habits, and you might be trying to, quit the ha remove the habits that don't work for you, don't serve you positively, and instead replace them with new ones. And you're trying to, restructure your daily routine, your daily habits there. But something here, I feel like something here, it doesn't work. Whether it's something here is on the verge of a collapse, or it is collapsing, or it has collapsed, okay? So the tower, yes, it's calamity. Yes, it's disaster. It might even be an impending doom. But it's like you're either going through a storm, you've entered a storm, or you're about to exit a storm. But this storm, you have to trust when I say this, it is not disrupting your life. It feels like it. It seems like it. I mean, surely that's what it's doing. No, it's not. It isn't. It's not disrupting your life. It is redirecting you. Okay? So if it feels like rejection, or if it feels like a collapse of some sort, or if it feels like, this is the end. This storm, okay, whether it's an emotional storm, whatever this storm is, whether it's a financial storm, it is not here to disrupt your life. It's not here to disrupt your path. It is here because it is trying to redirect you. Okay? It's trying to redirect you, put you in a different direction. It's trying to declutter your life. It's trying to get you to remove people, things, habits from your life that don't work for you. Okay, there's no point. It's like there's no point on hoarding things that don't work for you, that you have no use for. So that's what this storm is here to do. It's here to help you out. It's here to clear your path, okay? And there are some things that are in the way of your path, and these things need clearing. Because if this storm would not have hit, you would not have been able to see the way forward. You would not be redirected, okay, onto the path that you're destined on. So you just have to trust that the collapse of something here is an opportunity to restructure your life. Nostalgia is, it's a big word, nostalgia. It is a big word. And I feel like with the Six of Cups energy, it's very likely that you might find yourself, and this is intense, but you might find yourself really yearning, okay? Really longing for something from the past, or someone from the past. It's like you want to turn back the wheel of time. It's like you want to go back to a certain moment. You want to revisit a certain memory, a certain chapter of your life. It could be as far as as far back as your childhood. And you want to do that because you miss how things were then. You miss the person that you were when you were in that time and place, or when you were with that person. You miss how they made you feel. You miss what you felt maybe when you were a child. Maybe times were so much more simpler, happier, more innocent. So this is a really strong feeling of like yearning and longing to go back to someone or something from the past. And some of you will be doing exactly that. some of you will be doing, like you're going to revisit a memory, okay? So you're going to go back to a time in your mind. For others of you, it's very likely you might even try and reconnect with someone just to try and recreate something from the past. Or even if you're not necessarily trying to recreate or duplicate something from the past, you just want to revisit something with someone. For others, it's like maybe you might hear from someone. Someone from the past might reach out to you. And in doing so, this person is going to bring back a rush of emotions, a rush of feelings and emotions that you thought you had overcome. But all of a sudden, it's like you hear from this person and you're all of a sudden and almost instantly, you're transported back to a place and a time. And it's incredible that this person has, you know, the power to do that, or that you associate, you know, that you associate this person with a certain time in your life that is just so meaningful and so special to you. For others, you're going back to something, okay? So you're not going, it's not like you're getting back with an ex, or it's not like you're, you know, bumping into a classmate or getting in contact with a childhood friend. I feel like you're going back. It's okay. You're going back to square. It's like you're going back to square one, but it feels like you're going back to something you love. So you could be going, you could be finishing up one job, leaving your job to go back and do something that you've always wanted to do, but you didn't have, you kind of didn't have the guts or the courage to do it, or you just, I don't know why you gave up on this, because it was such, it was and it always has been a part of you, but now you're finally going back to it. So it's like you're going back to something that you loved. Maybe something that you loved doing as a child, maybe something that you thought that you were going to do when you were a child, like you thought you were always going to be a musician, but you grew up to be, I don't know, a doctor or a firefighter instead. I don't know, it just feels like you're going back to something that you've always wanted to do. Or you don't have to necessarily quit your job to go back and do something that you've loved. You could take it up as a hobby, you know, something on the side. But I see that you're going back to something, okay? You could even find yourself like rewatching old films, listening to music and just playing that over and over again on repeat, on loop, just because it takes you back. So nostalgia is very powerful, and I feel like, you know, you're really going to be overcome with nostalgia here. It's this, and some of you might even write, like you might use nostalgia as an inspiration for a project or for like an artistic piece. There is travel here for some of you, or there is a movement. There's a lot of action you're going to be taking. And for some of you, it feels like things have been really quiet. Things have been very still, maybe even a little stagnated. And then all of a sudden, I see you taking a lot of action. You have a lot of energy, okay? The Two of Wands is energy. It's fire. It's passion. So it could be because you're going back to something or someone you love, and there's love and there's passion there, and you know that's what's igniting you, that's what's keeping the fire burning. It could be that all of a sudden you're really inspired. You're inspired to travel, you're inspired to take action, you're inspired to just get up, get out there and move. You could be taking dancing lessons, dancing classes. You could be entering competitions, you could be taking up a sport, you could join a gym, you could start like working out. You're moving, okay? There's a lot of charged up energy here. You could be moving homes. Some of you could be relocating, okay? You could be going back to, you might go back to a place where you lived, to a house that you once lived in, or to an area that you lived, or you could be moving back, like you could be moving countries, moving back home. Flying back home to visit home. Home is a very big, like it's a keyword here, home. The Two of Wands is a reminder. Notice how the Two of Wands is placed below the Ace of Cups, and the Ace of Cups holds a chalice here. There's this oversized hand. that, you know, is pushed out through these billowing clouds, and it holds this overflowing chalice. And then in the Two of Wands, the figure holds the globe. It's a reminder that you hold the key to your future. The future is in your hands. You hold the key to your happiness. Some of you, you've slipped the key to your happiness in someone else's pocket. Why did you do that? Why? It's like you've given someone else permission to your own happiness. Or you only given yourself permission to be happy around a special, like a specific person. Or you've given yourself permission to be happy when this and this is going to happen. To be happy when, you know, things are going to start working out. That's not how this thing works, okay? You are responsible for your own happiness. So if you are that person that slipped the key to your happiness in someone else's pocket, I want you to go and take it back. That key belongs to you. Okay, so Two of Wands, some of you are, you know, you create your own luck. Some of you, I think, are thinking about taking some drastic action or making some sort of big, bold move, which feels exciting but also scary. But you're scared that it won't work out. You're scared that, you know, maybe it's not as good as you make it out to be. Just remember that, you know, you're the author of your own life. You're the manifester. You're the creator. You're your own author. You get to dictate how this story goes, okay? And speaking of stories, make sure that you're playing. That went blurry. Make sure that you're playing the main actor, okay? You're playing the main character in your story. Make sure you're not playing, you know, you don't cast yourself as a supporting character in your own story. That's important. I feel like you are becoming a different creature entirely. I feel like you are going through a transition and a transformation and a phase, and you're going through growth, which is, you know, why this tower moment or two or several is so important to you. Why, you know, certain people show up in your energy, in your life, even if these people bring nothing but conflict. Sometimes people are an example of, this is going to sound mean, but it's not mean-spirited. It's not intended that way. But sometimes people are an example of what you don't want, or who you don't want to be like, or what you don't want to be like. It's like they provide a contrast, right? And sometimes people show up and you're like, no, this isn't what I want. It's good, because in not knowing what you want, well, that, you know, that highlights what you do want. So some people, if nothing, they provide, like they tell, like they provide a contrast. And they tell you what you don't want, or what you don't want to, or who you don't want to be like, if that makes sense, okay? But you are becoming a different creature. So some of you, you are going through a transformation where you are shedding your skin, you're shedding different layers. And I mean, you're not the same person you were yesterday, okay? And you won't be the same person tomorrow. You're constantly growing and changing and evolving. And right now, I feel like there's a lot that you're going through. You're going through a big transformation. And transformation doesn't feel comfortable. That's how you know you're growing. And to me, it feels like you're just becoming a different creature entirely. You're becoming a newer version of yourself, a more authentic version of yourself. All right, guys, and I'm going to leave it at that. Thank you for your time, your energy, your attention. Please show your support to the channel by liking and subscribing. And happy Thanksgiving.